last goalie to get an assist.
Did Sarmiento have one? Maybe. I don't know. Yeah, I think he did.
I think he did.
Pretty
too.
Sure he did.
To kind of put, I guess, the wildness of last night behind you, and it seemed like you guys played a tighter, more controlled game overall. Did you feel the same way?
Yeah, I thought it's probably one of our best 60-minute efforts of the season. Maybe we were designed to give up the first goal. Maybe we played better. I'd rather give up the first goal and win the game than give up the goals in the third. So, but no, I thought we did a good job of controlling, you know, the puck, and that's where it all starts from. And I thought it started a little bit last night, and, you know, I thought we did even a better job tonight.
It looked like you guys were able to limit their chances a little bit more, and they weren't able to kind of grind you away in your zone. Did you feel better about that compared to last night?
Yeah, I mean, we backed them off a little bit last night with throwing pucks through the neutral zone and trying to get them, you know, they really do a good job of shrinking the zone with their defensemen, and we started putting pucks behind them early last night when we had the 2-0 lead, and, you know, I thought that backed them off, and I thought tonight it kind of continued, you know, and we had to make sure we weren't chipping pucks to them because they were backing off. So, I think that overall defensively we did a better job because, you know, they're a good team and they're older and they do a good job offensively cycling the puck, and you have to be able to defend because they're going to have their time in the offensive zone. You just have to limit the damage.
What can you say about the weekend Michael Leary had?
Really happy for him. I mean, that's what I just talked about with the team, is that, you know, with all the circumstances we had this week, I mean, it was challenging because Anders didn't practice almost the whole week. And you know, in last minute, you know, moving Michael to left wing when Joe got hurt was a huge part of our weekend, you know. And I'm glad he got a few points tonight, got his first goal, because, I mean, tonight he really started to show some, you know, positive traits to, you know, why we recruited him. You know, he played with a little edge. He's really a smart player. He helped that line. I mean, their 16's line for them is a real tough, grindy out type of line, and I thought Dawson Cook, unheralded, played well, and so did Benny Osley. That whole line, I thought, did a good job of containing and not bending. And, you know, at the end, they, you know, O'Leary had a goal, and then Cal Burke scored a goal playing with Cookie too. So, you know, if we can get that kind of, you know, grind out type of a line, kind of a grind line, and Michael certainly has a big impact on that because, you know, he's not afraid to use his size and makes good puck decisions.
Is the depth you've been talking about throughout the year, do you see it show up in a weekend like this where you've got Anders out last night and then Joe out tonight, and you're down a couple other guys that you knew coming in the weekend?
Yeah, I mean, it's really the youth depth, you know, because, you know, I thought that even throwing Felix in the middle, because we, you know, with O'Leary going to left wing, we really didn't have anybody that's practiced playing center, but Felix has had a history of playing center. So, you know, that's what you have to hope, that young guys can fill those voids. I thought he did a good job, you know, filling in the middle there too. So it's good to have depth, but it's the experience depth that really makes the difference. And, you know, these guys are getting experience under fire.
And to go be down 2 goals with like 3 minutes to go last night and come out of the weekend with 3 points, this got to feel pretty big, right?
Yeah, against a team that's ahead of us in the standings, and, you know, certainly, you know, I'm proud of our guys for their effort tonight. So, you know, it was a 60-minute tough playoff type of game. You know, that's what we're going to face the rest of the way.
So, Coach, obviously O'Leary had his first collegiate goal tonight. Do you have any comment about the play of your younger players as a whole tonight, as a number of freshmen and sophomores popped up on the scoreboard?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I can't say enough about, you know, Andrew Ogilvy and, you know, Cal Burke. Jack Jenkins deserves a lot of credit for his tenacity. You know, it was good for O'Leary to get going. You know, it's nice to see the younger guys, you know, as the season progresses, you know, to get a little bit more understanding in their game and how we have to play to be successful. And they complement that because, I mean, all those guys play with a little bit of energy and edge, you know, which you really need to have this time of the year.
What were your thoughts on your team's ability to find the back of the net this weekend as you scored 4 in each night?
Yeah, I mean, but again, a lot of it has to do with our being patient, you know, doing a good job with the puck. You know, if you're making bad puck decisions, you're chasing all the time. You know, if you're making good puck decisions, you're on offense all the time. So, you know, I thought that for the most part, we did a really good job managing the puck this weekend, and that certainly paid dividends tonight.
And then kind of looking forward to next week, what are you looking to see out of the team on the road at Maine?
Well, I got tough, you know, they're a tough team in their own building. We actually play in Portland on Friday night and turn around and play in Orono on Saturday. And they're an improved team. You know, they give Providence all they can handle this weekend and in Providence. So, you know, we're going to have to be prepared. It's a smaller barn, you know, and they're usually a team that plays a high-tempo game. And, you know, again, it's going to be a boil down to our puck decisions and our defensive transition, things that were much better tonight.
How up to speed was Andrews tonight?
Oh, he's not. He wasn't 100%, but, you know, he's still a threat out there every time he's on the ice. So, you know, I'm glad he got in the lineup. You know, just it actually created matchup issues for them. So I'm glad he was able to get back. And, you know, he skated this morning. He was at our meetings. And he had a tough week. You know, he was really under the weather. So it's good to get him back and hopefully back to full strength this week.
Walk me through that big assist.
It was a pretty routine play. Luckily, there's just no goalie at the other end, so we can get a nice finish. I mean, I just played it and hopefully thought that maybe they'd put it in or something like that. But
we found out before you got in here that Steven Summerhays is the all-time leader in goalie assists with 5.
Yeah.
So
I got to get some
work to do.
A little offensive prowess to me.
To go from where you guys were with about 3 minutes to go last night, and you're down 2 goals, to taking 3 points out of this weekend, how much of a boost is that for you guys?
Yeah, I mean, it's huge. And, you know, I think it's important, too, that we realize, you know, the hot teams are the ones that do the most damage in the playoffs, you know, come this time. And I think we have an opportunity to take a lot of momentum from this weekend. And, you know, with these next – you know, 6 games, you know, they couldn't be more important for, you know, Hockey East and then the national pitcher. So, you know, it's huge, and I think should give a lot of guys, you know, some confidence.
It looked like overall you guys were able to kind of hold down their chances a little bit more than last night. Did it feel like that from your perspective?
Yeah. They did a good job of just keeping things in front of me, which is the biggest thing, you know, not having too many threats, you know, off to the sides or back door or anything. And so, I mean, that was great and clogged up the middle well. But, you know, Vermont's a really, you know, persistent team and, you know, do a lot of good things. So it's really a big win.
Given the guys out of the lineup, and Anderson comes back in tonight, he's not 100%. Joe Wegworth is out. How important was it for you guys to get some contributions from some younger guys this weekend?
Yeah, it was huge. You know, that's something that we've been, you know, kind of looking for, you know, the whole year. And, you know, it's obviously tough for young guys to come in and make an impact right away. And I think, you know, like I was saying, probably the biggest thing is just those guys having confidence, you know, playing in larger roles and being successful and being able to make a, you know, a legitimate, you know, part, you know, of a big victory for us. So, you know, they should be really excited and, you know, really proud of the production of guys, you know, like Mike O'Leary and Felix and those guys.
Kind of mentioned about the younger players contributing a lot. What was the team's reaction to O'Leary getting his first collegiate goal tonight?
It's huge. You know, everybody was pumped up. You know, those are the guys that, you know, get the team going. You know, just like Bo Brower's goal last night. You know, you might not see those guys' names on the score sheet every night, but they're huge parts of the team, and they contribute in different ways. And it was great to see, you know, a guy like that get rewarded with his first points and goals.
Yep. So already mentioned earlier, but coming from behind both games this weekend obviously has to be a boost of confidence for the team. What are you hoping it generates moving forward in the last few weeks of the regular season?
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, like I said, you know, these next 6 games couldn't be more important, you know, in both regards. As long as we take the momentum and, you know, not get comfortable with having a successful weekend, and, you know, we're going to a tough place in Maine, you know, this upcoming weekend. And I think if we come with the same desperation, same fire, we should be successful and, you know, hopefully build on that and, you know, snowball it into the playoffs.